Signal naming is a powerful software feature which basically allows you to label all the blocks in your diagram with minimal effort. For example, let's say I have a Blue 100 with four mics connected to these analog inputs. So I'll select this card, go to its properties, and click the button next to Signal Names. Now I can type in the names of my sources. In this case, I'll just call them Mic 1. I can press Enter to quickly advance. Mic 2, Enter. Mic 3, and Mic 4. And when I click OK, those signal names appear within the analog input card. That alone is useful, but what's really useful is what happens when I connect other processing objects. As you can see, the signal names flow downstream automatically. So now if I need to know what signal is passing through a processing object, I simply read the text within it. Very useful. With any Soundweb London design, the first thing you should do is add meaningful labels to inputs, as I did here, and that small time investment will pay huge dividends from that point on. Signal names can also be manually altered anywhere in the signal path if needed. That's because the signal names property is not unique to the analog input card. Instead, it's available to nearly all processing objects. For example, if I click the EQ for Mic 3 and go to Signal Names, whatever I type will now flow downstream of the EQ. You might have noticed that the default entry was a dollar sign, which is one of three special characters you can use with signal naming. The dollar sign inserts, or really preserves, the incoming name. The pound symbol inserts the processing object's name. And the tilde inserts the output name. So, since the dollar sign is the default entry for most processing objects, that explains why signal names flow automatically. In this case, I'm going to change it back to the default dollar sign, which is the recommended setting in most cases anyway. A few processing objects have a noteworthy effect on signal naming. The source selector, by default, will pass through the name of whichever signal is currently selected. For example, I'll add one in and connect it to these three mono music sources, and I'll change it to three channels. Now I'll double-click to open its control panel. And if I select input 2, then the signal name Jazz passes through. If I select input 3, then Classical passes through. Here's a quick tip. If you want those names to appear on the source selector's control panel instead of just numbers, then enable the property Use Signal Names. And there they are. This makes the control panel a bit easier to work with. Anyway, the source selector makes the text dynamic. If I want it to be fixed, for example, maybe I want to always see the generic word music, then I can make that happen in the signal names property by replacing the dollar sign with the word music. Now the actual song is changing, but the signal name remains the same. Another processing object which has a noteworthy effect on signal naming is the mixer, which always interrupts the flow of signal names. After a mixer, the signal name becomes the name of the mixer itself. Therefore, with mixers, it's best practice to type a meaningful signal name into either the name property or the signal names property. Either property can be used, but the advantage to using signal names is that it allows you to decouple the name of the object from the signal name it generates. Everything I just said about the mixer, that also applies to both auto mixers and the summer. And similar concepts apply to the matrix mixer and the matrix router. With the matrix mixer or matrix router, the input labels on the control panel are determined by the incoming signals. But the output labels are determined by whatever you type in the signal names property. And lastly, the crossover will automatically append the word band and a unique number to signal names. As always, this behavior can be customized within Properties, Signal Names.